Welcome to Highline Excel 2013 class video number 3. In this video, we want to talk about how Excel calculates formulas. Let's just look at an example here. We have beginning quantity, ending quantity, and a value. And we need to figure out cost of goods sold. Well, first, we need to calculate how many we actually sold. So there's 7. So 7 times 5 is 35 bucks. That's going to be the cost of the items we sold. Here is a formula, and this is actually a question I got. And the person asked this question, hey, I made a formula, and this is the formula, and Excel is calculating incorrectly. Can you please tell me how to get Excel to calculate this correctly? Well, the problem was not with Excel, because Excel knows math order of operations. And so what's happening here is multiplication is done before subtraction. So if you don't know your math order of operations, then getting Excel formulas to work can be quite difficult. What it did here is 5 times 3 is 15. So 10 minus 15 is minus 5. And that's how we get minus 5. So I have a question for you. And we'll see how to fix that in just a moment. What's the answer to 8 plus 2 times 2? Is it 20 or 12? Well, when in doubt, go ahead and have Excel do it. So it equals 8 plus 2 times 2. It's 12. And the reason why is because multiplication is done before addition. If you want to see Excel in action, there's a great feature. You go over to the Formula tabs and Evaluate Formula. This great feature, if you click Evaluate or Enter, see, notice that button is blue. That means if you would hit Enter, it will enact that. If you look up here, it says Underline. That means, hey, I'm going to do multiplication first. So it calculates 4, and then 8 plus 4 is 12. And that Evaluate formula will come in handy when we do some more complicated formulas, and we have an error, and we're like, which part of the formula is calculating the problem? Hey, if you really want to force addition first, then you have to use parentheses. So 8 plus 2, the parentheses force the addition to be done first, and then times 2. So what's happening here is 8 plus 2 is 10, times 2 is 20. So back up to formulas and Evaluate formula. Now, this is something I do a lot. So I know the keyboard, Alt, and you see that formula pops up in M. So you hit M and then V for Evaluate. Alt, M, V. And there it is. So now you can see Underline is under the subtraction first because it's in parentheses. I'm going to hit Enter. It evaluates that. And then it says 10. It actually has to get rid of those parentheses. And now it says, hey, 10 times 2 is 20. Evaluate formula, a great trick. So here is the order of operations for math. We got to do our parentheses, our exponents, multiply and divide left to right, and then add and subtract left to right. If you don't know this, then getting your formulas to work can be quite difficult. So we don't want to do this for calculating inventory value. We want to go equals, open parentheses. Hey, we're going to take our begin quantity minus our end quantity in parentheses and multiply it by the value for each. And boom, our cost of goods sold is properly 35 bucks. Hey, let's go over to the sheet how formulas calculate. This is very helpful to know your math order of operations, but Excel has a bunch of other things it has to consider too. So we're going to go over here too. How formulas calculate, and here is the list of how it calculates. It starts with parentheses first, then it goes to reference operators, colon, space, and comma. Now, colon we've seen before. We know that if we give it a range of cell, it has to evaluate that and then get all the numbers and throw them back into the sum. The intersection operator, I will show you an example of it, but it is incredibly obscure, almost never used. Comma. It's called a union. That's very important because you can actually add different ranges or cell references into the sum function by just adding new arguments and adding commas. Negation comes third, then converting percents. If you ever type a percent into a formula, that is, I don't think I've ever done that for a robust, efficient formula ever. I suppose it's possible, though. But if you type this into your formula, it actually calculates it to get to the number. Then we have exponents, then multiplication, division, left to right, adding and subtracting left to right, ampersand. And the last thing that is evaluated when evaluating a formula is comparative operators. Now let's go look at some examples. All right, we're going to look at a few of the items from that list. Now, the colon is easy enough. We all use it. We may just have never thought about it this way. Of course, it has to evaluate that colon to see what numbers are in that range. Now, watch this. This is interesting. If we use Alt-MV and use Formula Evaluator or Evaluate Formula, it just underlines it and evaluates it in one single step. There's going to be sometimes that the Evaluate Formula dialog box will not show you all the steps. And then that way, I'm going to click Escape there. That's why our F9 key is so important. Now, it's a great little trick is if you have your screen tip showing, if you click on the argument, it'll highlight everything sitting in that argument. It's easier than like dragging and highlighting. Now, if I hit F9, you can see, sure enough, that colon has to be evaluated to find, oh, there's these four numbers before the sum function can add. Now, you could control Z. However, Escape will always get back to whatever was in the cell before you put it in edit mode. So this formula was already in the cell. So when I hit Escape, it goes back to that range. And intersection, this is this strange thing that you will never see. The only reason you want to learn this is so you can do it as a party trick. All right, watch this. I'm going to highlight. OK, that's a row, and a space operator, and then highlight another range, in this case a column. If there's an intersecting value, and you can see right there it's 25, that space operator says, hey, go get that. Now, if you happen to do, and I don't have a cell for this, but I'll do it just to show you, space, and there's no intersection, then you'll get null error. That null error means there's no intersection. Now I'm going to leave that there. All right, now comma. Again, if you ever have to do a two-way lookup of an intersection of a column and a row, we'll see how to do that with formulas, lookup formulas that are more efficient in the long run than the intersecting space operator. But that's good for a party trick. You could bet someone, I bet you I could get the space to do an intersection. All right, hey. Comma, we've seen this perhaps, but let's just imagine we want to add January, but not February and March. Well, we can just comma and go and highlight as many ranges as I want in the sum function. Now, this is the sum, but you could be doing average, max, min, any what are called aggregate functions that look at a bunch of numbers and calculate a single answer. Just comma, comma, comma. It's a union here. It means it's going to go get all of the numbers before it adds and then delivers an answer to the cell. So the colon is first and then the union comma operator. Again, these are not things you really need to think about too much because that seems automatic. Now, negation. Negation just is like a negative. So if I said equals minus 2, and I'm going to use the caret, that means raised to the exponent. 2 raised to the second power, or 2 squared, is 4. But guess what? That minus sign, if you really wanted to say take the opposite, that's what negation means, take the opposite of this calculation, this isn't going to work because the negation operator there will operate on the 2 before the exponent. So what's minus 2 times minus 2? A negative times a negative is a positive. So if you really wanted to have a negation of that operation, again, you'd have to do it in parentheses like this. Force the exponent to happen first, and then the negation. Percentage, I would never do a formula like this, but 10 times 1%. I don't think ever once in my whole Excel life if I typed a percentage into a formula. Maybe I'm just not doing the right formulas. Now, I'm going to enter this one. And actually, we'll run all three of these with Formula Evaluator so you can see. I'm going to run this one right now, Alt-MV. And you can see up there, it's underlining the percent. So when I hit Enter, it converts it to a number. And now it can calculate 0.1. Escape. I'm going to click in this cell, Alt-MV, and run the Formula Evaluator. Notice it's doing the exponent inside the parentheses. And it gets the parentheses, and then it takes the opposite of that. Alt-MV. Here, it's just going to do the whole operation, because that minus 2 is sitting there. Minus 2 times minus 2, or raised to the second power, gives us 4. All right, multiplication, I'm just going to make something up here so we can watch it when we run Formula Evaluator. Equals 6 times 2 plus 10 divided by 2 minus 7. Now, it'll have to do the multiplication and then the division first, and then go back and start over left to right, and then do the adding and the subtracting. So if I Control Enter, now let's run Formula Evaluator, Alt-MV. And let's watch it in action. Multiplication first, then division. Then it goes back to the front, addition, subtraction. And we get our answer of 10. The ampersand, now this is going to be a wild one. I would like to notice over here we have a start and end date for our project. Well, we learned last week our formula for number of days. So I'm going to say n minus start. But since this is a project and we want to include the first day, we have to add 1. So we get 4. That's the formula right there. Notice it did the adding and subtracting left to right. But now I want this to be a label that says the project lasted 4 days. So text in a formula has to be in double quotes. So I'm going to say the. Now I misspelled a word there too, but I added a space there, because I want there to be a space between the math calculation and this text here. Now notice how everything is black. That means it's not a valid formula. When I type the ampersand, the join symbol, the color comes back on. That means it's a valid formula. That sometimes for longer formulas is quite helpful to watch. When the color goes away, you know there's a problem somewhere in your formula. All right, and now I want it to say the project lasted 4 days. So I'm going to come to the end in ampersand. Now remember, I want to add a space. So I'm going to double quote space and then days, period, end double quote. Now I'm going to spell check this while it's in edit mode, because once you enter it into the cells, then spell check on the surfaces of the spreadsheet won't catch misspelled words inside of text inside of formula. So I'm going to hit F7. The project lasted. There we go. And it says you're good to go. That's new in 2013. It didn't used to be as casual like that. It's trying to keep up with Google and Apple. All right, Control Enter. Now, the whole point of this is let's watch. What gets calculated first? Is it going to be math operators or the join symbol? Well, from our list above, we know it's the join symbol comes second to last or penultimate. So I'm going to Alt-MV and watch this. Enter. Oh, it's doing the date. It's getting rid of the formatting. It's looking what's in that cell. So it's got 2 serial numbers. It does the subtraction. Then it does the next math, left to right, adding. It gets, and now it goes back to the front and does the ampersand. And then the ampersand a day again, and we get our label or text formula. I'm going to click Close. All right, how about the last one, which is comparative operators. So I have max day allowed for this project. I'm going to say equals, are the max days allowed greater than or equal to, and now I'm going to take my end minus my start plus 1. So here we have math coming near the end and a comparative operator at the front of this equation. According to the hierarchy of how Excel calculates a formula, or Excel's order of precedence, it better do all that math first. Alt-MV. Well, it looks like it's going to look in the cell reference. Then it's going to look in the cell reference. Then it's going to look again in the cell reference. Do the first adding or subtracting. So it does the subtracting, then the adding, and then it goes back to the comparative operator. So that was just a little example of some of what is in this list right here, how formulas calculate. Later in the class, when we get bigger formulas, we'll see that knowing this complete list can help us shorten formulas in certain circumstances. And in other circumstances, it'll help us just get the right formula in the first place. All right, next video, we will actually look at some increase-decrease problems. All right, see you next video.